Yeah, I don't know how well you can see this at night time on the GoPro, but 4 a.m. to load it up, heading to the Springs Four-Drive Park in Queensland. Should be arriving around 1 o'clock, 1:30. Phew! Let's get it. Heading up Thunderbolts Hill. This is a long, steep climb. We're just chilling in first gear, going 20 k's an hour. EGTs are sitting at 411. I don't know if you can see that. Gearbox is about 110. Water and everything else is good. But yeah, we're just cruising. Big girl on the back. No point in rushing it and making your car play up for no reason at all. So what do we got here? Mr. Waze says we've got about, what was that, 443 kilometers to go. Oh, you didn't make it very far. There's some water there on the side of the road. People fill up in case you need it if your car overheats. Such a good idea. But yeah, should be at the Springs around 11:20. It's about 6.5 hours from home. But big Effie boy's going good. We're just cruising. And stopped in Gloucester at my bro's for a coffee. So we'll get up this massive hill. Goes for like 4 hours up into the sky. So it just keeps going. As you can see, we're still climbing. Can't see on the camera how steep it is, but for the people that know Thunderbolts Road or Thunderbolts Way, you know how big this hill is. So we'll just keep on cruising, and we'll see you either at the Springs or, I don't know, if we see anything that might be camera worthy, I'll show you on the camera. Righto. We have arrived at our destination. Here we are, people of the YouTube. The Springs Four-Drive Park. What is the time? We went back an hour, 11:40. We left at 4:30 this morning. Here we are. A few hours up the road. Phew! Let's get into it. Righto, we made it. I don't know what you call this campground, but we've made it and we're down here. We're just about to pull the GU off, swing everything around, and we'll sort set tent up, set the camp up, and give you a bit of footage, and then wait for the rest of the boys to get here and stuff, and go for a bit of a drive later on this afternoon too. Hopefully beer o'clock will be in this episode. Righto, let's get this big girl off. Brax has found some shade. We'll get her off, set up, and bring you along on the journey, eh? Hey guys, here you go. Here we are. We found a spot under deadly gum trees, but we want a bit of shade. There's really nowhere else to go. Anyway, this is the spot to be apparently. What I wanted to do quickly was show you what my beautiful wife got me. Early Christmas present. I've seen these online and I said to her, I wouldn't mind a couple. So anyway, what you do, like you said, you can go either way, but let's just, for this example, you put the hook up there. I'll put a peg in the ground. Oh, here it is. Peg in the ground. That's not in there real good. And watch this. It's on a ratchet. Boom, done. None of this guide rope stuff going, oh, the thing doesn't work. Ratchet. And then to release it, you just push on that little bit there. Boos. Off you go. And then to do it again. Boos. Watch this. On a ratchet. Bit of rope. On a ratchet. Done. That's pretty cool though. Missed all of that.
Like, here I go.
pull it out and cover it anyway. Pretty good. Looks like he needs a bit of hand from me now. Oh, don't get out of it. I want a winch up. I'll rescue ya. He's gonna need a bit of winching, isn't he? Oh, he's gonna get it. He doesn't want to be pulled out by me. Oh, he's gonna get that. You bastard. I think steer this way, Jeff, now. I just said that, I was like, damn it! Boys and girls of the YouTube community, check this out. LSP. We'll open her up. Oh, I've got to get down with the old man knees. Oh, shit. Open her up. This is a recovery kit that LSP do. This is a sick aim. They got the massive big, pretty sure it's a recovery, like a tow strap, tow rope there. Got a tree trunk protector. Comes with two soft shackles. One's already on the back of the GU because we just used it. I had to pull Jeff out of, Jeff from doing it in the dirt. He got stuck up there, had to pull him out. Fair bit of stuff, Gucci little block there, and then you got a nice little shovel in here as well, which is cool too, when you want to dig your poos in the bush, so you don't put toilet paper everywhere. But you can find these on the LSP's Instagram page, in the link in their bios, got their shop. Ooh, and jump on there, check out the bucket hat too. I'll be wearing this bucket hat all weekend, because we're up at Springs Four Wheel Drive Park here in Queensland. Hot as, maybe like 40 degrees tomorrow. Got a Gucci shirt that I'm gonna be wearing. I'll be putting that on very soon, actually, party shirt. So stay tuned, check out LSP, give them a follow. Here's the Addy right here, give them a look and get on it. Righto, first.
You can drop in a rocky highway backwards as well, yeah?
What's it called? Hardcore climb. Let's go, let's do it. Wow.
me?
I'll just grab it for a photo quick. A bit of right hand down. there, go full lock left as much as you can. And come back. Keep going left if you can. Keep going, keep going.
Hard left.
Yeah, as hard you can. Yeah. Yep, and come back at that. Keep coming nice and slow. Righto, now go right and down. Right hand down and drive forward. Keep going right as you drive. Yeah, as much as you can, right hand down. Slippery.
Rear locker, bruh. Rear's not.
I've got no, nothing's leaking. I'm getting the air clean.
Yeah. No rear. Yep.
So around about now, this is where we find out the Murray lock is not working again. Just after we had a rebuilt locker put in by my good friend Bradley, he rebuilt the locker, fiddled with my diff gears and chucked it back in just before this trip, and all was working well until around about here. Yeah, you'll see later on in the vid, what, or maybe not this vid, next vid, what we end up doing to it. But we did have to pull the sender out 3 times, I think, to rectify the issue. But we found it, fixed it, and all is good. But yeah, obviously this little track here, I really wanted to get up, but.
Here you go. Start turning right. I think so.
He's not on anything.
No, he's clear.
There's a big rock against the back tyre, but should be right. Yeah, keep going, it's coming across. It's going to feel a bit uncomfortable.
Keep going. No, you're right. There's a
big rock on your tyre, but it should be
right. Nice and slow.
You can keep going at that,
Joe. Your front passenger is about to start climbing the rock. So your front passenger is going to come up.
Got it.
Oh, cool. Was it brown tape?
Yes.
Oh.
A boof hole.
The front's sort of just climbing to the top of the rock. Yeah. They're sort of getting wet on that rock.
Go right hand down. Far out. Woo!
Righto, so I do have to finish the video here. I've had to split. We've got too much content, which is cool for you guys, cool for me. But I'm going to have to finish it here, watching this animal get to the top of this step. So this little track here is used in the winch competitions. And Pete, in the hovercraft, as you're about to see, just hands it up there. Gets to the top and belly down on the rock, which you can't help. We ended up having to winch over the top of it. But obviously got further than what I did and everyone else did too. We'll finish it here. Next episode will be at 2 weeks. Second half, we'll have Beer O'Clock Hill. Where everyone has a good go getting up.
Well, you got to the top.
Come down or? Winch up.
Probably winch up.
Winch up.
If you go back
slow. Righto, thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers, guys.
What about keep going back here and then go left hand down maybe? And forward.
Fuck, it's a long way down there.
Yeah, don't come this way. Go left and forward maybe.
there, straight from there if you can.
You're gonna need to bump it.
There's a rock on the passenger side.
So forward or back?
Forward.